see here, this is through my Gmail account. You can see that I've been accepted into the YouTube Partner Program, and I've made a couple of videos already on this channel about this topic, and I would like to give you some advice in this specific video to like speed up your process so you can get monetized too. Yeah, we're just gonna start here. Don't be shocked, because I have like a plugin. It's called Rex something, I believe, and it says that I am not monetized, but that is cap, because if you look here at the home screen, you can see the join button, and this join button is only available if you are in the YouTube Partner Program. So my channel is in fact monetized. I'm monetizing my channel through, in this case, super stickers and such. I will show you. I'll go to the YouTube Studio, I'll go to my analytics, and where is it? Wait a minute, where is it? Yeah, here is here it is. You can see here, you're a YouTube partner. What I'm currently using is memberships and supers. I can also attach a shop, but I haven't done that yet since I don't have a shop at all. Now the thing is, there's a catch actually. Like, although I'm monetized, I'm not fully monetized, because if we scroll down, you can see that I haven't reached the 4,000 watch hours yet. And that is when you get like the real money, the big money, the like the YouTube ad revenue, which is something I'm really looking forward to. But I am already grateful to be in the YouTube Partner Program, because this was a very long struggle to me. I can go to the analytics here. If we go to like the last 365 days, you can see that I have like slowly gotten myself the watch hours throughout the months. If we go to click on watch time, you can see there are like 28 hours here, a couple hours here, a couple hours there. And this happened throughout the months, actually. Unfortunately, I wasn't consistent. Like you can see here, I didn't get a lot of watch hours here. This was like a whole month, I believe, of not uploading, of like barely uploading. And then I started uploading a lot more frequently in January, like you can see here. And then it stopped again. And then I did it again, like here in, when is this, March? And then it stopped again. You get the point. Now, my first tip that I would like to give you here is to stay consistent. People tell you to upload, for example, once a week. The thing here is that if I uploaded once a week on this channel with this topic, I wouldn't have gotten the 4,000 watch hours at all if I only uploaded once a week. But that is like, that's not the thing here. The thing here is, what they mean by uploading consistently is that you won't get things like this right here, where you're stopping for weeks straight due to like a burnout or no motivation or no discipline. Because it is better for you to choose like a specific schedule that you can maintain. So even when you're not motivated, even when you're not disciplined, or when you're sick perhaps, you can still upload a video, no matter like in what situation you are in. That was not the case with me. I didn't have a plan. I had like no specific day or specific time to upload. I just started to create content randomly, and it did work, but it's very close. Because if we look at the beginning here, you need to get the 4,000 watch hours within 365 days, and the 365 days period have passed in my case. Like you can see here, I am currently losing watch hours. Every day I will lose watch hours. Tomorrow I will lose 0.4 watch hours. So luckily for me, those watch hours like aren't that big of an issue until we reach August, and that is in like a month. So I have 30 days left to get the remaining watch hours. So I'm actually very, very close to losing all my progression. Like I can go to the last 28 days, and you can see that I have gotten myself almost 700 watch hours this month alone, and that is because I was really stepping up my game. I was like, I need to get into the monetization, because else, let's say we'll get to August this year, I will actually lose 30 watch hours on August 6th. That means if I get like, let's say 10 hours on August 6th this year, I will actually lose 30 as well. That means that despite me putting in effort to create content that day, I will actually lose 20 watch hours, which is extremely demotivating. I wouldn't be able to handle that actually, especially in October. Let's say I didn't manage to get into the monetization in October, I would lose 30 watch hours, 20 watch hours consistently throughout the months. I would be like, how am I ever going to catch up with the watch hours that I'm losing, right? So never, like, I don't want you to do that. So my first advice is to always stay consistent. No matter if it's like one upload a week, twice a week, it doesn't really matter. As long as you stay consistent, this will help you to prevent these burnouts, like you can see here actually. Now, the second advice that I would like to give you to monetize your YouTube channel quickly is to upload long form videos from the start. And I will explain to you, this is a mistake that I actually made, because if we're going all the way back to my first couple of videos, I did create some long videos as well at the beginning, but then I started to create short form videos, and those videos appear to be doing well. Like you can see here, make money on Pinterest in 2 minutes. This video got 9k views, and this 1 minute video got 4k, this 1 minute video got 4k. You might think, why is it a mistake? Because you managed to find like a video idea that a lot of people are willing to watch. Well, the downside of this is, although I'm getting a lot of views, if we're going to my analytics, you can see that despite me having 4k views on this video, I only gained 50 watch hours, and that is pathetic. Look at this. I can go to my previous video, like my recent videos. Let's say we'll do this one. This video only has 1.6k views, but has already gotten me the 44 watch hours. So that's the same for like twice as less views. And I can give you an even better example. For example, which one will we choose? This one, I think. Look at this one. This video doesn't even have 1k views and has the same amount of watch hours compared to my 4k views video of 1 minute. And you might think, Jason, if you didn't create those videos, you wouldn't have gotten those views at all. That is not true, because if we scroll past the short videos, you can see that my long form videos, where is it? Let me look. This one, for example, about Digistore, is 11 minutes and has gotten me 5k views. This one, make money on Pinterest, 9 minute long and has gotten me 5k views as well. And if we go to the analytics of this 9 minute long video, you can see this is a ridiculous difference. This video has gotten me almost 300 watch hours, just this one specific video, compared to my other 1 minute video that has only gotten me 50 watch hours. YouTube, at the beginning of YouTube, your YouTube channel will get like a boost. This is for beginners. Beginning YouTubers will actually get a boost. As long as the content is good looking and all right, your content will be pushed out a lot more compared to channels that have been on YouTube for a while. Actually, I got that boost on my 1 minute videos, unfortunately. So I wasted a lot of watch hours. If those 1 minute, 2 minute videos would have been 8 minutes long or 10 minutes long, I can guarantee you I would have been in the YouTube monetization program already. So due to this one mistake that I made at the beginning of my journey, I am now not in the monetization program yet. Like, I can show you, I need like 300 watch hours or something, which is very unfortunate. I could have been earning a lot of money right now as we speak. So from the start, create long form content, as long as the content is filled with useful information, because your audience will not watch longer videos if there's no value within your content, right? So some people will make like a video of 8 minutes, like 4 minutes of actual content, and then the remaining 4 minutes is like garbage. You don't want that. Now, the third tip that I would like to give you when starting a YouTube channel is be in one specific niche. I see a lot of new YouTube channels out there, very like beginning YouTubers out there, who create content randomly about random topics. Like, for one day they're gonna create a content about a room vlog. This is my room. The next video is like playing GTA right now, playing a video game GTA. And the next day is going to be like how to install Windows Movie Maker on your laptop. Like, what are you doing? Like, what? Like, no one is going to watch that content consistently. You're reaching everyone. Like, you're all over the place. And that is not what you want. You want to be in one specific niche, creating content about one specific topic that a certain type of people are interested in. And that is how you build an audience of people who are willing to return to your YouTube channel to rewatch your old or new videos. And that will, like, give a signal to the YouTube algorithm that a lot of people like your content. And that is how YouTube will push your content to a lot more people organically, else you will get a dead channel. And I can show you an example. This is one of my other channels in which I create shorts. I can show you here that the reason that my short videos are getting so much views is due to me reaching a very specific audience, and that audience likes that specific content that I'm creating. And all I'm doing is like using that strategy, using that formula, basically redoing it every time. Like, it's just a skit, basically. It's just skits, but about a very certain topic that my audience is consistently interested in. So I'm not creating a skit about football, and then I'm creating a skit about, I don't know, video games, and then I'm creating a skit about cars. I'm not doing that. I'm creating skits about a very small, certain, like, specific topic. And that is how you get views consistently. I can go here, the last 306. I'm not even doing this for like a year, but like you can see here, on April, it really took off, and now I have 2.5 million views, 24k watch hours, and 7,000 subscribers. And this counts not just for YouTube Shorts, but also regular content. What you should do, in my opinion, is, depending on your motivation, I would advise you to choose a niche that you have somewhat knowledge of, or that you are like interested in, because YouTube is a very long process. You're not going to become rich quickly. You're not going to like get monetized quickly. Like you can see here, I've been creating content for over a year and I'm still not earning a single cent. Most people would have given up by now. My next advice that I would like to give you is to do research within your niche. The content that you are seeing right here isn't unique. I'm going to be straight up with you. The topics that you are seeing, for example, make money with Pinterest CPA marketing in 2 minutes. This isn't new actually, because I've been doing research within my niche and I've seen someone else creating content about how to make money on Pinterest in 2 minutes specifically. And I saw that that guy on his channel had a lot of views on that video specifically. So I tried to copy that method, that formula, and it took off at the beginning of my YouTube channel. That is how I got my boost, by actually doing research. The same counts with all the different videos. The top 5 most profitable niches, make money on YouTube with one video. All those ideas come from other channels that have done the same thing. And you might think, Jason, that is stealing content. But in my honest, humble opinion, this is how YouTube works, because YouTube is also a business and you should copy strategies that are already working. Why change something that works? Copy strategies that other big YouTubers are using that actually work and give your own unique twist to it. Everyone does this. Even companies like Samsung or like Apple, they all steal. They all look at each other. They all look at the competition and they steal things that are actually working, because they don't want to like get out of business, you know. They don't want to be left behind. Because that will have a huge impact on their reputation, their sales, etc. So as long as you give something unique, like a unique twist to it, you should be good. And what you can use to find video ideas within your niche is to use VidIQ. This is a free extension that you can use, and you can search anything basically. And I've done this myself. I am in the make money online niche, and what I could do, for example, is like simply make money. Okay, it's simply make money online. I will press. Okay, this is, I typed make money online, brother. Enter, you can see that the search volume, and you can see the competition. So this will give you very specific information about what your audience is actually looking for, so you can target your audience effectively. So now you know that people are actually looking for videos regarding Kittle. So you can make a Kittle tutorial for people who are wanting to make money online. That way you can target your audience and they will find you more easily on YouTube. Depends on the content that you create. This is my next advice that I would like to give you. Let's say you're in a gaming niche. What are we playing? Fortnite. You can see that the search volume is extremely high, but the competition is also very high. And you can see that this audience is looking up for XP glitch, Fortnite chapter 5, season 3, Fortnite reload. The difference with gaming content is this is entertaining content. So people aren't necessarily looking for your content. But if you are doing something educational, so let's say affiliate marketing, these are topics that people are actively looking up for on the internet. So this means that with entertaining content, your audience won't look for your video actively. You need to try and reach them. But with educational content, such as how to start affiliate marketing, how to do affiliate marketing, people are actually trying to find you instead. And that way you will get yourself a lot more views through like YouTube search, for example, or like Google search. Your video will rank higher that way because people are actively looking up for your content. And because you're giving them such value, they will be more likely to watch your video for a longer period of time to see how you're explaining that specific topic, and you will get a lot more watch hours more quickly. So that's a difference. You have entertaining content and you have search-based content, also known as evergreen content. Even if you are in a gaming niche, you could try and create search-based content or evergreen content. For example, if you're playing video games, you could like how to get the best weapon in this video game, or how to create this specific tool in this video game, you know? That is search-based content, and I can show you proof, actually. This is one of my gaming channels in which I'm not monetized anymore, but I would like to show you that the... Look, I'm gonna show you here. This right here, playing zombies with your friends after school, be like... This is just entertaining content. It didn't get a lot of views. You can see Jason reacts to the Battlefield 1 official gameplay trailer. This didn't get a lot of views either. But if we're going down to bots gameplay in Modern Warfare, bots confirmed, bots in Modern Warfare, these type of videos people were actively looking up for, because there is an audience within that specific video game that doesn't have internet connection or like good Wi-Fi at home, so they can still play against bots to have that multiplayer online experience. And I knew that because I was one of those people myself. What I did here was explaining how the bots worked in that video game. I showed them the settings, the type of weapons they could use, and people were actively looking up for this specific content. So you can see that although the average percentage viewed was only 12%, which should be like, it's criminally low. If we go to the reach, I assume you can see that 80% of my viewers came from YouTube search. 80%, that is ridiculous. How much is that? That's like at least 100k views just from YouTube search. So if I didn't create this video, if this video wasn't informative but instead entertaining, it would have gotten better views. So it's crazy how much difference search-based content can make compared to entertaining content. So keep this in mind. Now, a bonus tip on how you can monetize your channel more quickly is like, we're all going for that YouTube ad revenue, right? The 4K watch hours. But you can monetize your channel more early, of course. And how you can do that is through affiliate marketing. So affiliate marketing is promoting someone else's product to the right audience. So you need to promote a product that is actually like interesting to that specific audience that you are trying to reach. And I do this myself. So if we go to one of my videos, it really doesn't matter. You can see that in the description, there are links in there. Now, in this video specifically, there's only one link which redirects them to my personal like landing page that I have made, where people can click on specific products, which are all affiliate links that they can genuinely benefit from. And if they pay something through this affiliate link, I will receive a commission. So what you could do, for example, is actually create, let's say you're creating educational content. What you could do is like give a tutorial about a specific software. So for example, VidiQ is one of those tools that can help people to grow their YouTube channel. And you are actually like the right audience because you are trying to grow your YouTube channel. So what I could do in this case is promote VidIQ to you and give you like a reason as to why you should use it to enhance your YouTube channel, like to enhance your content creation. And what I can then do is implement an affiliate link in my videos. So I can show you, let's say this is one of my affiliate links, the VidIQ one. You're gonna click on it once you sign in and buy like a subscription, I will receive a commission. That way I can start to make money while I'm not even monetized on my YouTube channel. And this can be very effective as long as you do it the right way, because you can't just promote a random product that you're not going to be interested in. You're not going to be interested in an Xbox controller, right? So it doesn't make sense for me to have an affiliate link to Amazon where you can buy an Xbox controller with discounts. That doesn't make sense, right? Anyway, well, these are the tips I think there's more, but these are the tips for now that I would like to give you to help you get monetized more quickly, like at least within 365 days. I can show you here. I have gotten myself almost 700 watch hours in just this month alone, so I can guarantee you that I will make it. I will actually reach the 4,000 watch hours next month, because if we're going to my eligibility, you can see that I am currently at 3,570 watch hours, but this is from June 19. So if we're going to count this, we're going to get our calculator. Okay, Windows calculator ain't working. I have no clue why it doesn't work. Anyway, okay, we're gonna use a calculator from Google. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is 3568. These are our watch hours right now. This is from June 19, right? So this isn't from today, June 19. We're going to my analytics. So you can see June 19. This is where I got 24 watch hours. So on June 20, I will get another plus 25 watch hours. So we're gonna press enter. Then I will be like at like 3593. And then we're gonna get another 22 hours on June 21. And then we'll get 35 on June 22, and then we'll get another like 12 plus 12 on June 23. So this means that I am currently at 3,660 watch hours. This means that I need to get like only 340 watch hours, and that is easily doable to reach in like 1 month. And I still have this month left as well. I have like 5 days left or so this month alone. So I can guarantee you I will make it. Yeah, so that's that. I hope you found this video interesting, and I will see you in the next video.